Good afternoon, everyone, on this Monday bank holiday. Just finished my cup of tea. So, we'll just get it a few more minutes, let it all work, get everyone online, get ready to work out. Drop me a hello when you're online. Let me know that you're here, because I know the notifications take a bit, so we're just going to give it a bit of time to start with. Just check if this is too bright in here for you, or if you can see me okay. Pull the curtain a little bit. That's a bit better. Afternoon. Can't believe how sunny it is, but it's absolutely freezing out there today. Been out before, it's freezing. Still time to get out though, isn't there? So I'm just going to let the notification run because it just takes a few seconds for it to come on people's phones and stuff like that. Today we're going to be doing four exercises and we are going to, it's a full body as always. It's just body weight today, so no weights, but on Wednesday we are going to need some weights if you have them, and that can just be tins of beans, that's absolutely fine, that's for Wednesday. But I'll talk about that more at the end about what we need for that workout. So today we're going to be doing some alternate lunges, but they're side lunges. We're going to be keeping our legs in the same place. We're going to do some shoulder taps and some arm raises. So we're combining two exercises into one. And we're going to be doing some squat pulses and some press ups. And that can be on the wall, in a box position, on your knees or foot, depending on where you are in regards to your recovery and your strength. So they're the main things that we're going to be doing. Then we're going to be doing some glute work as always. We're doing hip raises today, so we're going to do three different types of hip raises and they're going to be a minute each, those ones. So we'll just give it, if it's only 1 minute past 1 o'clock, so we're going to give it a bit of time. Hi Kirsten, you okay? Nice to see you. Hope everyone's had a lovely Easter. We did actually have an awesome Easter egg hunt in the garden yesterday, and I was quite amazed at how on it my two-year-old was, which was great. He knew exactly what to do. I couldn't even finish the glues, and he was there getting all the little tiny eggs, which was ace. So we're gonna just give it another minute and then let everyone on. So as soon as you jump on, just say hi. If you're watching this afterwards, say hi. Hopefully you're able to get outside because it is beautiful again. Cold wind, but beautiful. And if you don't get outside with this session today, then get out for your government approved walk, obviously. And I know Babby Active are doing a finding colours on the trail thing at the moment. We went out and found a red flower on, I can't remember what day it was, Thursday maybe? Or Friday, can't think. But yeah, we went and found a red flower, and that was actually harder than you would think. So yeah, hi Jeanette, you okay? Happy Easter Monday to you too. I think the only difference is my partner's here and not working, because he's always here anyway working, but he's not working, so less stress today, definitely. Cool. We're going to get started, if that's all right with everyone. So we're going to start with our nice warm-up. Like we always do, we're doing body movements, then a little bit of stretching. So I want you to start marching on the spot in 3, 2, 1, off we go. Let's go for it. Nice march on the spot. Hopefully the light will stay equal in here because it's just a bit bright, but I'd rather have the sunshine than the curtains drawn, that's for sure. So nice marching for me, just keeping that those shoulders back, that chin up, and just try and keep those legs as straight as possible, okay? Good. Hopefully we can burn some of that chocolate off today, and then you can have some more. That's exactly what I'm going to do anyway after my lunch. You can have some more chocolate and another cup of tea, and maybe a film after my walk. Good. Okay, we're going to go into those light squats. So, make sure those knees aren't going in the toes. Down and back up. We're not hitting the floor. We're making sure those knees aren't collapsing in. Just nice and steady. We're just warming up, remember? Getting those arms involved. Good. That's it. Nice and warm. Definitely, with my patio doors, I get very warm in this room. Okay, last one. Let's keep going. Okay, let's do those lunges again, okay? Right, step back into that lunge. Down, back up. Back into the lunge, good. That's it. Where's my balance gone this morning? That's it, breathing out as we're coming back up. Just warming it all up. And swap legs. Nice and steady, get your balance. Remember, we're not going very low, just nice and warm. If you're in this position, perfect, okay? Just warming up, remember. That's it, keep going like that for me. Okay, wrist rotations. So our wrist rotations in one direction and the other direction. Brill. Okay, big arms for me, so I want forwards first. Get some nice rotation warm-ups in. And backwards. That's it. Just making sure we're stretching right up. All the way around, as big a circle as you can make. Brilliant. Okay, just a few quick stretches. So forwards, linking those hands together. That's it. Pushing out those shoulders. Okay, now backwards, the one that's really important at the moment because we are hunched quite a lot. Open up that chest. Get those arms as far back as you can. Brill. Keep doing that stretch for me. Good. Okay, up high, I'm going to go to the side of this one as well. So those arms, those fingers interlinked. Up high, and then we're going to go over to the side. Not too far, remember, just so you feel the stretch down here. And then breathe out, back to the middle. And over again. Good. Just getting all that movement in, okay? Lovely, right. Quick stretch of the legs, really, really quick. Just make sure we are nice and warm. Pushing back into that back leg, down into our heel, stretching that calf out. Shoulders and upper body nice and relaxed. 3, 2, 1, swap sides. That's it, good. So as you jump on, just say hi, what you've been up to, anything like that. Or you can just get on with the workout as well. Brill. Okay, we're gonna do our heel down, toes up, straight leg. Push down onto that straight leg, push that bum right back. Stretching all this hamstring here. Make sure our back isn't curving over like this. Nice flat back. Brill. And swap legs. Definitely feeling tight from not doing much over the weekend. Brill. Okay, give your legs a shake. And those arms shake. I'm going to get ready to work out. So, our first one is alternate lunges, but we're doing side lunges. So I want you to go into a nice wide stance, as wide as you can go. Make sure those hips aren't pushing forwards or back, okay? Want them nice and neutral in the middle. I'm going to go down into the side lunge, hands on hips or right front, and we go down. And then push back up with this leg. Down, push back up. Okay, so you breathe in as we go down. Remember, all of these exercises are postnatal specific. They are a good workout for anyone at all. But always remember that you're 6 weeks postnatal if you have had your check, if you're lucky enough to have your check, or 12 weeks post C-section. Listen to your body throughout all of the workouts. You need to make sure that you are listening. I'm not there with you in the room. So I want you to really listen to your body. Any pain isn't good, okay? Exercise pain is different, but pain in your hips or in your back, actual pain, is not what we're looking for, okay? So I will give alternatives and modifications to all the things that we're doing, but just take it steady, if you're, especially in that early point of postnatal. Okay, so side lunges. The modification is you just go down to this point here and back up. Try and not lock those knees out, back up. Okay, and the stronger you feel, the more you want to get out of this session, down, back up. Don't lock the knees. back up. Use those arms to drive up as well. Okay, down, pushing back up. Down, pushing back up. Okay, everyone ready? In 3, 2, 1. Off we go. Nice side lunges. Down, back up. Do it at your pace, okay? If I'm going too quick for you, you slow it down. If I'm not going quick enough for you, you speed it up. Brill. That's it. Just make sure that bum is going all the way back and the leg you're working is bending, not going over the toes, and knee doesn't go over the toes, okay? And 10 more seconds. Brill. So there's 4 exercises, 3 times with our rests in between, as always. 2 and 1. Lovely. Right, we're doing shoulder taps and arm raises. So I'm going to go this way because of the sunshine. Now, if you're early postnatal, you can go into this position, in a box position. If you're slightly later and your core has recovered more, I want you to go into the half plank position, okay? As long as that core is strong enough to hold you there. If you're doing this, it's not. Go back into that box position. If you feel any coning or any too much pressure on your core, back into that box position, okay? And what we're doing is we're doing arm raises. Shoulder taps and arm raises. So we go, breathe out, 2, up, down, up, down. Tap, tap, up, down, up, down. Okay? Kind of like a dance routine. Everyone ready? 3, 2, 1. Off we go. The more advanced version is into the half plank. Tap. Tap, shoulder, there you go, okay? Just keep that pace. 30 more seconds. Try and keep those hips as steady as possible. Hands underneath the shoulders. That's it, the other option is in that box position. Tapping that shoulder, raising and raising. 10 more seconds. Good, make sure that back is flat. Good. 3, 2, 1. Stop there. Everyone back on your feet. Early postnatal, take your time, knees together. Bring yourself back up. Okay. So hopefully you're doing it at your pace, at your level where you're at, okay? We're doing squat pulses now. So we'll go wide. We'll go wide today. We'll work those glutes again, okay? Nice and wide. Down. 1, 2. Pulse back up, okay? That if there's any pressure on your pelvis or that feels too much on your pelvic floor, I want you to go down, down, and okay, nice and steady. Everyone else, I want those pulses. 2 pulses, breathe out, come up. In 3, 2, 1, off we go. 1, 2, drive those arms. 1, 2, good, that's it. Just keep it going. Nice and smooth. Make sure those knees aren't going to come over those toes. Don't lock those knees out either. Keep them soft. Brill. That's it. Just keep it moving. 15 seconds. Good. Just keep it going. Okay, you're going to feel it now. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay. So I'm going to stall a little bit before I pass out. We're doing press-ups now, so there's 3 options. You can do, well there's 4 options actually. You can do wall press-ups, box press-ups, kneeling press-ups, or full press-ups. If you're doing full, you know where you're at with that one. If you're doing wall, I think Natasha did this one in her class the other day. Get a bit of wall, I haven't obviously got much wall here. Hands either side and we press down and come back up. Okay, I can't do it on my wall there, I've not got one. If we're doing half and box, same position as what we were with the shoulder taps. So box position, breathe in and out. And then if you want to make it a bit harder, go into that half plank. Ensure that core is working at all times and it isn't dropping down like this or too much pressure on it. And back up, okay, and then full. You know where you're at with those. Okay, 3, 2, 1, off we go. So I'm going to do some box for you.
Good. We've got 30 more seconds on this one, okay?
Then that's our set done, and we're doing it two more times. So we've got a 40-second rest after this. We get a nice drink. Brill. Where are we at? 15 seconds to go. Don't keep those feet down. Lovely. 10, 9, well done everyone, keep going with it. 5, 4, 3, 2, last one. Brilliant. Okay, 40 seconds. Get yourself some water. If you've got any questions, drop them in at the bottom for me. Say hi if you've just jumped on. I'm also going to be doing a talk afterwards. So I've just realised my notebook's not in here, so I have to go and grab that. And we're just talking about kind of your tummy area and your body after having a baby, to be honest. Nothing too in-depth, but just more of a general chat, so it'd be really good to stay on for that. Just a bit of a chat, if you have any questions or how you're feeling or anything like that, just jump on. We're going to stay on here rather than going over to the other page. It'll be a bit easier. Okay, lunges. 3, 2, 1. Off we go. Now concentrate on that breathing for me. And those arms. Don't lock those knees out. Good. All the way over. That's it. Get those legs a bit wide if you need to. You're halfway on this one, okay? So if you can get lower, get lower. As always, any twinges, just take it steady. That's it. Lovely. Let's keep it going. 10, 9, all the way down with this one. These really work. Especially when the legs are staying static. And stop there. Okay, shoulder taps, arm raises. Let's get down on the mat. I'm going to do it in the box position again, okay? You can do it in that half plank position if you're feeling strong enough. I'll move back so you can see what my arms are doing. Okay. Off we go. Breathe in and out. We shoulder tap, arm raise, arm raise. That's it. Breathing out on these efforts. So it's a nice long out breath, okay? Or you're in that box position doing this. Keeping everything neutral. Gap between your knees. Making sure everything's aligned at all times, okay? 10 more seconds. Keep it going. And then you're halfway through. 2, and 1. Okay, everyone up on your feet, remember. Nice and gentle if you're only postnatal. Squat pulses. So I want those wide, we're going to go wide again, okay? I think more beneficial with what we need at the minute. So we're going nice and wide, again, too much pressure on your pelvis, just bring those legs a bit closer together. You're going to squat down and do 2 pulses. Off we go. 1, 2. Breathe out and drive as you come back up. 1, 2. 1, 2. That's it. 30 more seconds on this one, okay? I want low squats. If you feel like you can, get lower. And if you can't, just keep doing what you're doing. You're still doing it. That's it. 1, 2. Drive. Remember to breathe out. That's it. 10 seconds. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lovely, right, press ups. Okay, so your level of this as always, you'd be so bored of me saying that. Down into your position. Making sure you've got that nice clean space, the core is engaged. If this is happening, pull it back in. And if that is too much, into that box, 4-point contact. Okay, 3, 2, 1, off we go. Breathe out as you come back up. That's it. Make sure that core's engaged. When you feel, if you feel too much pressure as you get to a certain point, stop at that point. Come back up, okay? We're building up nice and steady. It's all about timing, all about that postnatal journey. And it's all about doing what's right for you and your body. Three, two, one. Okay, brilliant. That's the beginning already. Okay, so grab another drink for me. And we'll get going again. All right. So we've got 20 seconds in those alternate lunges. And we're just going to make sure that that bum is coming back nice and smooth, okay? So, we need to make sure those knees aren't coming over our toes, but that we are pushing that bum back. So as we go down, that bum is going back, okay? All the way down. Three, two, one, off we go. Down, back up. Down, back up. Good. Just breathing through it. That's it, just keep it moving. Hopefully you've got some good music on in your house. Hopefully you'll feel these as well. I always feel these ones after I've taught them, always. Keeping those knees slightly soft, not locking them fully out. And five, four, three, two, and one. Shoulder taps, arm raises. This is our last round, so make it count, everyone. I'm going to dive onto the floor. You've got 10 seconds to use your rest. Either box position or half plank. If you've been feeling that you may try it, this is your point to try it and come out of it if you need to. Off we go. Okay, hands under shoulders. Keep those hips as steady as possible. Breathing as controlled as you can. That's it. Takes quite a lot of concentration, this one. We're combining two exercises here. Trying to get as much out of this time, this short window that you're going to have. And five, four, three, two, one. Finish there. Right, back on your feet. Again, steady as ever. If you feel like you can jump up, jump up. It's more exercise. Right, 10 seconds. I'm going to go wide again. Nice and wide, so we can go nice and low. Working those glutes more than those hamstrings and quads with this one. Pulsing. Off we go. One, two, drive. One, two, drive. And breathe out as you come up. That's it. Good. Just keep the momentum. Keep this momentum, 20 more seconds. That's it. Just keep it smooth. Keep the rhythm. And you've got 10 more seconds. Come on, ladies. All the way, all the way. This is your workout, your small window of half an hour for you. Brilliant. Okay, press ups. I want these shoulders really working at the end of this one. So whichever option you're choosing, wall, box, heart on your knees or full, your choice. And in, five, four, three, two, and one, off we go. Last exercise. Core engaged. That's right, breathe out as you come up, okay? Come on. 25 seconds. You ought to see how far you can get with these ones. Just keep it going. All the way to the end, ladies. 15 seconds. Keep it going. Press ups are tough. Whichever one you're doing, they are tough. And 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Last one. And you're done. Okay, everyone, grab that drink. And then we're sitting down on the floor, so make sure you can see the camera, see the screen rather than camera. Take a nice drink. Not long left, about 10 minutes. So, if you have a resistant band, grab it now. If you don't, and you're able to go and grab a pair of tights that I found out the other day,
Natasha was saying the other day, you can use tights. I was like, awesome idea. Go and grab a pair of tights so you don't mind being stretched, okay? So I'll give you a few minutes to get that, and then tie them in a knot around your knees. Okay, so I'm going to put these ones on. This is just one of my bands that I use. It was on Amazon. I don't know whether you can still get them at the minute. But the good ones to get that are, where are they? You can get packs of them. Pretty cheap. Are just these loop bands. These ones, this was like a pack of four, I think. So you can get these on Amazon for like £6-7. They may have gone up at the minute. They've been a bit cheeky. But when they get their new delivery, you'll be able to get them again. These are great because you can use them for so much. Or you can get the long, thin ones as well. Where are they? I've got one of those too. It's tied at the minute. I used it the other day. But these, again, physios use these. You can get them just loose, like just a loose one on its own. Or a pack of three off Amazon. And they are so handy just to add that bit of resistance while you're at home. Whereas if you're at the gym, you'd have other things. But at home, we don't have that, do we? So, hopefully everyone's got their tights or resistance bands ready. I'm going to do a combination of different hip raises. I'm pretty sure you can all see me. First thing we're going to do is a standard hip raise. These are called loads of different things. They're called hip raises, glute bridge, glute raises, lots of different things. I'm going to call them hip raises for us today. And I want you to make sure your feet are flat on the floor. Okay? If you've got a band or tights above your knees, just at this point here, feet flat. So for 1 minute, we are going to go, we're going to move our hips up and down, up and down. We're then going to change it. So we have 20 seconds rest, we're going to lift our toes up and do the same. And then we're going to have 20 seconds rest and we'll do a pulse. Okay? So I'll show you that. We go out, we're going to hold it up and we're going to pulse. Okay? So hold it for three, pulse for three. But I'll tell you that when we get to those points. So first one, keep it simple. First one we're doing is just, you can either have your elbows down on the mat with your hands here, just keeping you nice and steady, or you can hold your mat if you're further postnatal. Okay? And we breathe in, and then out. Okay? Make sure you're not overextending and that we're coming up and down. You can also just have your hands on your hips so you can feel if they're swaying either side. The aim is to not let them sway, okay? The aim is to try and keep them as steady as you can, getting these glutes working together. So in 3, 2, 1, off we go. Just nice hip raises, breathing out as you come up, just nice and steady. Adjust yourself when you need to. Just tap down rather than lying down like this. I just want you to tap down, okay? That resistant band will just add that extra bit of balance for you, that extra bit of support and that extra resistance for when we're coming to do the pulses. So you're nearly halfway on this one, 30 more seconds. Bring those heels in if you feel like you need to work it more. Try not to let yourself slide backwards. 20 more seconds. Okay, so there's just 2 more minutes after this one. We'll get into our stretches and our pelvic floor, and then we can have a nice gym rag, so get your cups of tea ready. And 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, next one, same movement, but all we're going to do is lift those toes up. Now, if this feels too much for you, I'll give you a demo. If you lift those toes up, and as you lift up, you're doing this. Just keep those feet flat. Quite simple. Just keep them nice and flat to give you more stability. This is just an advanced movement. Off we go. Toes up. 1 minute. Up and down. So you'll feel this a lot more in your glutes. I want you to squeeze as you come up. Squeeze those glutes as you get to the top of your hip raise. Control that breathing, okay? Doing 3 minutes of hip raising, you're going to get some burn in those glutes. All good because we're keeping nice and stable. All right. Just keep the pace. Where are we at? Well over halfway. So I can always feel that my left glute is overpowering my right because I've got an injury in that glute. So that means I feel like I go this way. So I have to really concentrate on making sure that right glute is firing at the same time.
That's why doing these after we've done all our squats is great, because those glutes are all awake, ready to be worked. Last one. Okay, 20 seconds. Now, with the next one, a bit more complicated. Not that complicated. We're going to lift up, and you can either do this flat-footed or toes up. So that's the easier option, that's the harder option. And you lift up and you hold. 3, 2, 1, and then we pulse. 3, 2, 1, and we come back down. We're going to do it for 1 minute. Everyone ready? So 3, 2, 1, off we go. Hold. 3, 2, 1, and pulse. 1, 2, 3, back down. Your pace, okay? Holding it there, and then pulsing. If I'm going too slow, you speed it up. If I'm going too fast, you slow it down. Just as long as that hold is for 3 and the pulse is for 3. And then you come back down. Try not to lie down completely. Try and just tap down as you come down. That was a bit of a longer hold because I was talking. And that's it. 20 seconds to go. That's it, ladies. We'll go straight into our stretching. Keep the pace. Should be feeling the burn now. Make sure we're holding up, we're not dropping as we pulse. Get those hips up and pulse. 5 seconds. This will be your last one. Go back up. This is your last one. Hold it there. 3, 2, 1, and pulse. 1, 2, 3. Oh, felt that one. Lovely. Okay, bands off or tights or whatever you've got. Or if nothing at all, that's fine. Doesn't matter at all. Okay, we're going to go into, what time are we? We're going to do a quick stretch. So I want you to go onto your knees, open up and lean down as far as you can. Walking yourself down, heads down on the mat, stretching up back out, bum on your heels. Or as close as you can get them. Nice deep breaths in through your nose, out through your mouth. Lovely. Okay, come up to seated, and I want you to put your feet together and pull them in as close as you can get them, okay? Brill. Stretching out all here, so obviously doing those side lunges, we've worked that area quite a lot today. So try and just push them out as low as you can. Keep your head back, not like me. Brill. We do one leg forwards, reaching down as close as you can. If you've got a resistant band or those tights and you can't quite reach, loop it over and pull it back, okay? And then you'll feel the stretch more, and you can obviously hold a bit closer and you'll feel that stretch there. The aim of these sessions is to always make sure that we've got those advancements and that we can use stuff at home. So things like tights and cans of beans are great alternatives. And swap over. You'll always probably find as well that one side is tighter than the other. So it's always my right side, and that does stem from that injury I was talking about. But you'll always have to hold one slightly more or do a double stretch on one side. It can be your leading leg or your the opposite. Not your leading leg. Okay, both feet together. Down we go. Just as close as you can. If you can't get close, use something else. A tea towel is absolutely fine. Nice deep breaths. Lovely. Okay, we'll do one more because we've done those squats. So I want that leg crossing over, straight leg arm looped around that bent leg. And this hand here at the small of your back, looking over that shoulder. Holding it there, just some nice deep breaths in through your nose and out through your mouth. You just feel the stretch all up here in your glutes as well. And swap over. Just holding it there. Make sure we're not bouncing or pulling it too much, okay? That's not the type of stretches you want to be doing postnatally. Just want to be easing our bodies into that stretch.
Lovely. Okay, we're going to do our arms. So, we're going to do a couple of different ones. So I want these hands, I want them interlinked, but palms facing you. Create a circle as best you can. Might be more of an oval. And push those arms out so you can feel the stretch in your shoulder blades. And then we're just going to go over to the side, just slightly. Try and keep that head central, just making sure that torso is moving. Over to the side. And the other side. Good. Make sure everything else is steady and exactly where it needs to be. Okay, we're going to go up and do the same. So hands up. Make sure those palms are facing upwards this time. And then we'll go over to the one side. Stretching those arms and that torso out. Good. And the other side. Pushing that chest right out, getting those shoulders back. Lovely. Okay, roll those shoulders back and roll them forwards. We're going to do a couple of seconds on pelvic floor, a couple of minutes, sorry, on pelvic floor. So I want everyone to come back up to standing for me. Right, so this one, really, really simple. We all know how to do a squat. So we're going to go on into the squat position and we're going to be doing fast ones and slow ones, okay? So if you've come to the buggy active sessions, we do these, Abigail on the bit by the water, we always do these. So I just want feet hip width apart, not anything, or shoulder width apart, sorry, and just soft knees like this. So you take a nice deep breath in and we're just going to lift our arms forwards and push our bones back. So I'll go side on so you can see what I'm doing. And as we breathe, as we go down, we're going to breathe in. So I want you to breathe in and then breathe out. And as we do that, we lift our pelvic floor as we come back up. So this is what's called a functional pelvic floor exercise. We're doing this all the time. We're picking stuff up, picking children up. We're always doing that. Our pelvic floor reacts. But what we want to do is actually consciously make it work, okay? So we're going to do 5 slow, and then we're going to do some holding and some fast ones, okay? So take a nice deep breath in as we go down. Off we go. And then up. Holding it, lifting it up, and then back down. Okay, so it's a feeling as if you're stopping yourself from having a wee or stopping yourself from jumping. It's that kind of feeling that we're lifting up. Obviously, I'm not there with you, and that does make pelvic floor exercises online a little bit more difficult because I can't make sure that you're doing it properly with checking your chest and things like that. But make sure that you have that feeling, and it's not just a squeeze, it is a lift. And a squeeze, okay? So the squeezing is just activating it, but we want to make sure that we're actually working it and we're lifting as well. So we're going to do 4 more of those. So nice deep breath in. Back up. 3 more. 2 more. And last one of these ones. Excellent. Okay, we're going to go into a holding position. We're going to do the same motion, but we're going to do it fast. So we're going to do 5 fast of them. So we're going to engage and a release, engage and a release. Okay, so I'll go diagonally so you can see. So take a deep breath in. And now stay there and breathe out and engage. Engage, release, engage, release, engage, release, engage, release, engage, release, engage, release, and come back. Okay, a little bit more complicated, especially without me there in the actual person, but we'll give it another go, okay? So nice deep breath in, and again, breathe out, staying down, engage, release, engage, release, engage, release, engage, release, engage, release, engage, release. Lovely, come back up, and we'll go again one more time. So nice deep breath in, and breathe out, engage, release, engage, release, engage, release, engage, release, engage, release. Lovely. And relax there. Okay, so I'm just going to nip and grab my notebook, get a drink, and then we are going to, where are we at? Oh, Jess. Hi, Jess. Come jump on it later. Stay on now. We're going to have a bit of a chat about body confidence and your new body as being a mum. So even now, two and a half years later, definitely still feel my body is very different to what it was pre-child. So we're just going to have a bit of a chat about that and just air kind of some thoughts about it really and anything that anyone else has. Okay, any other thoughts? So just give me 30 seconds. I've got to go out there and come back in. Go and grab yourselves a drink and then be back on here in a few seconds. See you in a second. Okay, brilliant. Right, so I've got my drink as well. So I hope everyone enjoyed that workout. Obviously people will catch up on this afterwards, so there won't necessarily be questions on here afterwards. But if you do have any questions and you're watching this post, then I want you just to drop them in there or drop them in the inbox for Babby Active. And just if you put my name, then I can respond to it. Otherwise, have a listen. And some of this might be new, some of it might not be. Obviously, it's how I feel and how a lot of professionals feel about this. And there's a lot of mixed information out there for people, definitely. So, when we're pregnant, our tummies are the focus of everything. They're the focus of where our baby is, the focus of change. And it's also a really strong area for connection. So everyone always talks about your tummy, the size of your tummy, what it looks like, how's it feeling today, oh, you've grown, or you're looking small, all these things that people don't necessarily realise how much of an impact they make on mothers or mothers-to-be. And we talk about that quite a lot in our pregnancy classes because even if you are... even if you've got a small bump and someone says, oh, you've got a small bump, that can really affect you if you are worried about the growth of your baby or anything like that. So even when you're pregnant, there's all this change on your body and these external feelings and opinions and comments. So it starts from the minute you really find out that you're pregnant, that your body isn't your own anymore and it's growing your child, which is amazing and blows my mind every single time I speak to a pregnant woman or when I was pregnant, it's unbelievable. But after pregnancy, it can also feel quite disconnected. So whereas when you were pregnant, it was the focus of everything and it was where your baby was growing and you were holding it and it felt most of the time it felt quite solid. And it's just a whole new world, a whole new feeling. Afterwards, it can really feel disconnected because you've gone through these changes with your tummy. So it's gone from, it's grown, you've got the skin changes, stretch marks. I've obviously got my notes here just so I make sure I cover everything I wanted to. Your belly button changing, the hair on it or the line that you get, that can really kind of, that can still be there. I think mine was there till about 9 months afterwards. But all these things change gradually and bit by bit. And then afterwards, it's overnight, most of the time overnight, but it's within a day that you get these changes. It goes from being firm and full to being like soft and jelly-like and not like your own. And it feels weird and you have like these afterbirth pains. I'm just gonna close the door for 2 seconds. And you can have these afterbirth pains that are there and that no one necessarily talked about and you're suddenly feeling very disconnected from an area that was such focus. But the appearance isn't everything with it. So a lot of people worry, so you'll go and see a physio afterwards or, which I definitely recommend, going and seeing a women's health physio after you've had a baby. But it's hard when you've had such a drastic change so quickly to accept your body straight away and to accept how it is straight after. And I'm not talking days after when you still have
you still have that bump. I'm talking kind of weeks after when you're starting to do things again, so the 6 weeks plus over that time. There's just so much pressure to accept and love your body. It's made a baby, but sometimes you don't feel like that, and that's okay, and it is okay to feel like that. And it does take time. And I think as you come out of that newborn fog, you then, you know, you haven't really had a chance to even look in a mirror, let alone see what your body looks like. But you come out of that newborn fog and you suddenly start to feel this pressure, and you shouldn't. You should just feel how you feel. And if you don't like it, you don't like it. If you do, if you think my body is amazing and it is an amazing thing, I don't care how it looks like, then that is fantastic. But not everyone feels like that. I find it really hard as a sportswoman pre-pregnancy, always competing, always training my body and making my body work, for it to change like that when I've always seen gradual changes, be it through the work that I'm doing, the exercise I'm doing and what I was eating and the target I was going for, so whatever event I was training for, I saw my body change gradually, because that can't happen overnight. It happens really gradually. And then to have it change literally overnight, and to be there with a C-section scar and all of these things and a newborn baby, was like freight train kind of hitting. But I definitely didn't have time to think about it till about 12 weeks, that's for sure. But then I'd had trained for labour. You know, I talk about this quite a lot in my classes, that we're not training in regards to improving our strength, we're maintaining, but it's still a constant, this is what I do on this day, this I'm doing this for me and my baby and my body, and to make sure that I am strong. Nothing about weight, nothing about shape, it's about being strong. So I trained for labour and pregnancy and for afterwards, but my body wasn't responding in the way that I was used to, and it was really, really different. And it just, you know, I'd just given birth, so that's why it took me a very long time to accept how my body had changed and that my clothes weren't fitting anymore. And then I found a totally different style. I'm in Lycra 90% of the time. At least 5 days a week I'm in Lycra, which is very comfortable. But then my style has changed, so I'm not in those tight skinny jeans anymore that just aren't comfortable, because my tummy has changed and having the buttons there isn't comfortable anymore, and having anything digging in with my scar just isn't comfortable. 2.5 years later, I just don't find it comfortable. And so it's kind of finding this new path and this new way of that your body looks different. Even if you weigh exactly the same now as you did pre-pregnancy, your body will still look different because everything's moved and everything's changed to accommodate your baby. Everything has moved. My hips are different. Where I carry weight is different. Everything is different. And I think that isn't really talked about when someone gets pregnant either, that your body is yours. And a lot of people say, oh, you're going to get your body back and things like that. It's like, well, my body didn't go anywhere. It's still here and it's done the most amazing job it's ever done in the world. But it's different and that's it. I still fit into the same size clothes, but they're just different clothes from different shops, different styles, that type of thing. Whatever it is, however you feel, your emotion is valid, and it will always take time. It will always take time to get used to being a mum. But there's these little things that people don't talk about, and that's how your body's changed. And people don't talk about the appearance of it. People are always like, oh, well, you've had a baby, it's fine. But your emotions are valid, however you feel about it. And whatever birth you had, or if you have your ab separation or anything like that, your body still, your tummy and your whole body still needs TLC and still needs care. You are, after you've given birth, everything is about the baby. And obviously how you're healing, but most things are about the baby. The midwife coming around is about the baby. The health assistant is about the baby. But your body needs that TLC as well. And making sure that you're doing the appropriate exercises and they are appropriate for you personally and your recovery and where you're up to is key, definitely, because jumping straight back into something just because you did it pre having a baby isn't safe, because your body is different and your body is still moving, and you need to bring your strength back bit by bit. I say this all the time. It took 9 months to grow that baby. It takes 9 months for your body to recover, at least. Most people still find changes for a couple of years after they've had a baby, if not longer. If you have had your ab separation, then that can take a lot longer, depending on what type of separation you've had or how your body is recovering, or if you get pregnant again. All these things take time. So it's not an instant process, is what I'm trying to get across, and that you should, and that your emotions and your feelings are completely valid with the way your body looks and how you feel about it. It is how you feel about it, because the way you look is the way you look, and it is amazing, and you have grown a human. But the way you feel about it shouldn't ever be put down. You feel like that for a reason. So just take your time, make sure that you are always eating right and eating enough. A lot of people don't do that. A lot of people think, oh, well, I'll just grab this, I'll just grab that. And that's actually worse. You need to be making sure that you're eating lots of good things, and biscuits and whatever you want to in between. I lived off biscuits and boxes of roses, because my son was born in November, so it's great. Because that first year is tough, and you don't need to be tough on yourself about your body either. It's done an amazing job, and you should allow yourself to have those feelings and allow yourself to go down the right processes. So there was quite a lot of rambling there. I had no questions popping up, so I thought I would just make sure that I had something to talk about, and that it was hopefully useful. And if anyone ever wants to talk about anything like that at all, I'm always here, always got listening ears. So that's kind of my chat today. Hope you enjoyed the workout and it made you feel good, all about those endorphins at the moment. And yeah, I will see you all on Wednesday. And on Wednesday, we need, if you have resistant bands, get your resistant bands. And if you have any tights, if you haven't got resistant bands, and then weights, and if you don't have dumbbells, then things like bottles of water. I have had some random ones in my classes lately, but bottles of water, tins of beans, anything really that has a substantial kind of weight to it. If you can get anything that is 2 kilos, what's a bag of sugar? A bag of sugar is a kilo, isn't it? Most of them. But then you might get sugar everywhere, so let's not use those. So yeah, anything that you find useful, that will work, that you can hold properly, because we're doing some shoulder presses, and some bent over rows. So we're going to just need some weights that you can do that with. And if you don't have anything, you can still do the movements. It's absolutely fine. You can still do them. So I hope that was of some use, even if it was a bit rambly. And I hope the exercises have made you feel good and you get out for some fresh air today. So happy Easter Monday, everyone. And I will see you all on Wednesday. Take care. Bye now.